And so, Lord, as we look at this relationship between the potter and the clay firsthand, that we won't excuse it as just a demonstration of someone who has the ability to take something of nothing and to make it into something of something. But Lord, we would see it deeper and broader and wider, because the meaning of this relationship is deeper, broader, and wider than anything that we'll ever be able to grasp. And so today, Lord, I just pray that this would be life-changing, a nugget that can be held on to.
I believe that the Lord is shaping me into the godly man that He wants me to be only. From my past experience, I never knew what it was to become a servant, but He now has shown me what it really is, and I believe that everything I do is unto the Lord.
Before coming to Montana, God gave me a promise. He said, "You did not choose me, but I chose you and appointed you that you should go and bear fruit and that your fruit should remain." The clay doesn't have any idea what it's going to be when it grows up, and it's not trying to find out. It is simply yielding to the potter's hands.
Christianity is much more simple than I have made it out to be. Unqualified and unworthy are the qualifications for the kingdom of God. God desires my fellowship, and I want to sit at His feet.
I have faith and absolute confidence that God will do all that He has said according to His promises to me. I don't know yet what the finished piece will be, but it will be fearfully and wonderfully made by the Master Potter, a life redeemed to show others how big God is.
My life is yours. It is not my own. Do in me what you want and work through me to accomplish your will. The things that were to my credit I count as loss. If you want me in a hut in Africa, so be it. If you want me in a fire station in Wisconsin, so be it. I want to do your work and nothing else. Your plan is perfect, and nothing that I can come up with would even come close.
I have and am coming to realize, and today showed it even more, that I love to be seen. And that is certainly not a good thing. So I've come to the realization that I want nothing of the original self left, but I want all God in my life. That is the only way that He can do what He wants with me.
I have come to realize that God is more obsessed with me than the potter is with his clay. God's plans toward me are good, as Jeremiah 29:11 says, and above anything I could ever imagine.
Before letting go of my life and placing it into the hands of the potter, I did not understand what it truly meant to love Him. Through not allowing brokenness and vulnerability, I became like a stone, immovable and impenetrable. I went back and forth with the world and was crushed because of it. Through the many tears that brought me to repentance, I was softened and able to be reshaped. And God has now used the very thing that the adversary meant to destroy me as a tool to remake me into an entirely new vessel.
I do not know when, but I began to realize the abundance of joy that has been placed in my soul. Transformation has begun with such great detail. I almost didn't believe it, but to deny this would be foolish. Knowing that some huge burden, I don't know what, has been lifted is the greatest relief I've known besides getting saved. Realizing I can look to the vertical about everything, just between Christ and I.
In Psalm 18:35, it says, "Your right hand has held me up." Every time the potter shaped the clay, there was a hand on the opposite side holding it up. We can't stand on our own as He tries to shape us. We would just fall right over. Sit still and let the Lord do all the work. I want the Lord to look at me and not see clay, but His reflection.
Now take these things I have shown you and rest in peace, knowing that I am close to you. Everything you feel is me. It is all for my glory. You are being made beautiful.
I understood when the potter explained that the Lord had to break me in order for me to bear fruit. I looked at the finished project and truly grasped for the first time how great is the Father's love for me. It doesn't always feel good when He chips away or cuts off the parts of me that need to go, but He knows what He's doing. And I can trust in Him, knowing that One day I will be a grand masterpiece bearing the signature of Jesus Christ.
The potter can only use a vessel that is broken, not one that is hardened, and he needs there to be nothing left of the original self. The potter calls for all the rights of the clay.
But my God has really spoken to me, and he has really helped me see the way he sees true love. Love that never fails, even when the pot's so torn apart. Even when my thoughts start coming back to haunt me and telling me that I'm worth nothing. And that I would never be cleansed or forgiven. But guess who's there reassuring me that he's in control? He is.
Through many trials and tribulations, God broke me. He has delivered me from my addictions to substance abuse. He has revealed to me the sickness of my perversion, the seriousness of my hatred, the truths of love, and the purpose of our existence, in which he rejoices over, and that purpose is to rejoice in him, and in turn to share this with our neighbors.
Faith is living in absolute confidence in what God has said, even when the fullness of his promise has not been seen. I was looking for a verse that had something to do with brokenness, and I found in Psalm 31, he was saying, I am a broken vessel. And then I read on, and it said, but as for me, I trust in you, O Lord. I say, you are my God, and my times are in your hands. And that's so true. Our time is his, not our own.
Abba, you show me that the pottery process is in correlation to our relationship with you as a lifelong one. We never stop being molded and conformed to your image. It's a process that adds life and hope and subtracts fear and death. In you, I have life abundantly. Yesterday, I went to the potter's house. I walked in one person, but came out forever changed because of your love.
Master Potter, why do you labor all day, molding such worthless pieces of clay? Why such feelings in your hands? Why such care in every touch? Why all the struggle? Your creation is nothing but dust. And the Lord says, I'm molding a masterpiece, a work of great beauty. I'm molding a masterpiece. My labor is not yet done. A trophy, a treasure, a work beyond measure. I'm molding a masterpiece, Robert, a masterpiece of love.
My time with the potter is amazing. He stretches me, forms me, and just when I think I'm finished, he breaks me. I need to stretch me more.
At first, you were so soft and moldable, so I started working on you right away. Then you started to harden. You became stubborn and would not let me shape you. I put you on the shelf for 3 years, and finally you returned to me. When I held you again, I rejoiced. I poured my living water on you and covered you with my blood. Slowly, I am shaping you into the masterpiece that I have seen all along. Just wait and see what I have in store for you, your loving Father God.
Just be still. And know that I am God. I want you to see that you are here, now, and you are exactly the shape of clay I want you to be for right now. Do you believe me? Yes, Lord, I do. I get it. I am here. The Lord showed me yesterday that I am right where I am supposed to be with him. For this time in my life, he is calling me to draw close to him each day and to build that close relationship intimately with him that I've always desired to have. It starts here, each day, willing, allowing him to break me, mold me, and turn me into his perfect piece of clay.